Hello and thank you for choosing Translation Exchange as your localization partner. In this video we will show you how to integrate WordPress with Translation Exchange and get your WordPress site or blog localized in any language. Here we have a WordPress admin open, and what we have to do is to install Translation Exchange plugin. So we will navigate to plugins and add a new plugin. We're going to search for Translation Exchange. And here's our plugin. We'll click on install and then we're going to activate it. Once it's activated, you will see a Translation Exchange section on your WordPress on the left panel in admin section. Once you click there, you will see your project key and access token. And you can get that information from Translation Exchange dashboard. So let's go to our dashboard, to the project we created after we signed up. Once you get the login screen and log in with your email and a password, we will see the project that we just created. As you can see, there are no strings or sources because we haven't integrated yet. If we go under integration API keys, we will see our project key and access token. So let's use that key and token to enter them to our WordPress and save the changes. So now, integration is almost complete. So let's now add language selector so we can let our customers change preferred language. We provide a few different language selectors for our WordPress, and they're under appearance and widgets. And here's our language selector. You can see that our language selector is located on the main section, but you have different ways to place it. It depends on your WordPress implementation. You can place it on the footer, you can place it under a sidebar, or any other customized location that you prefer. We can see different styles of language selector. We have a list, drop-down, pop-up, and flags. So for example, we'll implement pop-up style selector. Now we can see when you go to our site that the language selector is there, and pop-up option is just a list of languages, and these are all languages that we selected in the dashboard for that project. We can always add more. Let's try to change language selector from pop-up to flags, for example, and click save. And then if you refresh the page, you will see that we have a list of flags. So I'll go back to pop-up for now and save it. Right now, if we select Russian, nothing is translated. So in order for our system to recognize new SDK installation, we need to enable translation mode. There are two ways we can do it, using a keyboard shortcut, which is Control-Shift-I. I goes for inline mode, which places ours inline mode. Or we can do it through the language selector where you can select help us translate. That puts us into translation mode, or we call it inline mode. It's called inline mode because we can translate directly on our site inside the application. Inline mode gets activated right away, and as we can see, all the strings are underlined with the orange dotted line, which means the strings got recognized and they're getting extracted. So if you refresh the page now, we'll see that some of the strings might be already translated. We can also see that some lines that have red underline, which means they're not translated. If we go back to our dashboard and refresh strings page, we will see the strings got extracted right away. There are 21 phrases, strings. So if we look at dashboard, we'll see there are 21 phrases, or we call strings, 55 total words, one collaborator, and four languages that we selected for that project. Under sources, you'll see only one source right now, which represents the web page URL for our WordPress installation. When we select Russian, we can see that some strings were translated using machine translations. So that's it for our WordPress integration. To learn more about how to use our SDK, perform translations, place orders, or learn about more integration, please visit our documentation site at docs.translationexchange.com. Thank you for watching.